Who is ready for the third video of the day?
Yeah, so this one I'm so excited to read. I showed it to Todoroki, like villain, reader, or listener. It's written by Nessa the Butterfly. I will be leaving a link to the fanfiction. And this is a one-shot, so there aren't any more parts, if I'm correct. And yeah, I am really excited. Let's just begin. There's something I need to tell you. Past. Hey, little child, are you lost? A woman asked. You nodded, but didn't say anything. Where's your mother? Don't have one. The woman smiled. Then how about I be your mother from now on? You smiled a bit. Sure. You held the woman's hand and strolled with her like she was your real mother. You thought you would be led into a happy life, but you thought wrong. Present. Name. Your name. I will just call you YM. Your mother called you out. Yes, mother? You responded. I'll be going out to do villain stuff. You still remember, right? Sure. See you later. She smiled and sank down in the floor. Wish me luck out there. You smiled back. Your smile faded quickly. You turned back and do your thing. Your supposedly mother popped up. We startled you. Did you forget something? Mother? You asked. I was thinking that you could help me in this mission. There are many people who are around your age, the Shadowcork lady suggested. That way you don't feel lonely and you can use the quirk of yours. Oh, sure, you faked smiled. Time skip. You and your mother were hiding as the group of students trained their butts off. Do you ever want to use your quirk? Your mother smiled. You never liked being told what to do, but you nodded as she would threaten you to do so. You had become a weapon, a gun. You shot air through to cause commotion. What was that? One of the students shrieked. Everyone was panicking. Stay calm, students. A hero shouted over the loud screams. You saw one boy who was staring at your direction. He has two different hair colors as well as mismatched eyes. He took a step towards and eyes appeared on his right foot. It spread straight towards the two of you. It caught your foot as you fell. Damn, you cursed. Mother, what do you think we should do? Well, I'm going to go and you stay here and keep them company. Mother, what are you saying? I'm not going to get myself get caught by those dweebs over there, so I'm going, bye. The Shadowcork woman fled, while a group of students along with the teacher ran towards you. Before you got yourself free from the ice, you were about to take a runner, but you twisted your ankle and fell. There's no point in running. The adult with tired eyes called out. Can't believe she left me with those people, you mumbled. Huh? What did you say, villain? Questioned a boy with blonde spiky hair. None of your damn business, you shouted with anger. I don't even know what you are talking about. I'm not a villain. My mother forced me to do it. So where is she? A girl who looked like a frog asked. She left you, didn't she? The boy with ice and fire quirk proceeded towards you and held out his hand. I'm sure Todoroki. You? You had no choice but to accept his hand and lifted you up. YN, LN. Ow. Shoto placed you on a boulder down to sit. Oi, Todoroki, why are you effing helping her? The explode quirk male asked with a full mouth. She's a villain's daughter. No, that wasn't my mother. She just took me in when I was young and developed my quirk so she could use me as a weapon. He looked down in disgust. I hate her. I really do. Then why did you... Izuku was interrupted. Because she used her quirk to blind me inside her witch house. She wanted me not to leave. Everyone was silent. They didn't know how to react. Shoto knew her situation was the same as yours. His mother was forced to marry Endeavor and trying to make a perfect child, which was him. As a child, he was forced to do really tough training season. Nobody understands. I was also alone from the start, you know? No parent, no guardian, nothing. A sudden hug came from Shoto and you jumped. What are you? You tried to push him away, but he spoke these words that made you feel something. I know how you feel. You paused and felt your tears flowing down. Huh? Why am I crying? You wiped your tears, but it kept going like a small waterfall. The group gathered, and one person held my hand. I'm Chakoraka. It's Midoriya. The broccoli-haired boy smiled. The frog-like girl cheered. See you, Asui. Katsugi Bakugo. And so on. After all the introductions, they all gone back to UA High School. All 1A students have their dorms. Shoto puts bandages around your ankles. Wish I sleep? You asked as you waited patiently. You can sleep with me. Ochako grabbed your arm while glee. Oh, okay. You smiled. A few hours later, you woke up and saw Ochako still fast asleep. I sneak out of the room. As you were about to open the door and take a stroll, you bumped into someone. Ah, Todoroki-kun? You rumbled my head. Can't sleep? He asked with his calm voice. No, I just woke up. Yeah? The half and half male responded. Same. Little did you know that Shoto began liking you when you got... Little did you know Shoto began liking you when you got with everyone in the group. The two of you were outside watching this night sky. Kirei. You looked up at the shining stars. Kirei means beautiful in Japanese. Okay. Yeah, Shoto was staring at you, smiling. Not in a creepy way, but you know. He leaned towards you and pecked you on the cheek ever so suddenly. You blushed so hard and pulled back. What are you doing? You blurted out. Sorry. I didn't know what I was doing. I don't know. Struggled to say the words, you giggled. Oh my god, sorry. That's such a voice crack. Cute. You whispered. Did you say something? Shoto questioned. I can't with my voice right now. No, it's nothing. Time skip. What's wrong with my voice? Okay, I just drank some Pepsi Max and let's get on. Boyan-chan, you woke up. Ochako was right in your face. What? You quickly lift yourself up and hit the ground. See where you already quirked. Go ahead with yours. Oh, sorry, you startled me. Deja vu, it's my fault. I went straight in your face and shouted. Ochako smiled while rubbing her head. Anyway, why were you sleeping in the living room? I went out to get some fresh air, but I think I fell asleep and someone picked me up. You then remembered it was Shoto who was with you. Shoto was there with me. Oh, really? She had a smug. She had the smug on her face. Tell me what happened. You stay silent. Shoto walked into the conversation. Such a great timing. Ochako spoke. If you're not gonna tell me, I'll ask him. What? No! You tried stopping her, but it was too late. The young girl skipped towards her chōrō, who was getting a glass of water from the kitchen. She called out, "Todoroki-kun!"
"Hmm?
What happened with you and Wayan-chan last night?" she questioned with a grin. Chōrō drank his cup and answered, "Nothing much, we were just looking at the stars. Wayan fell asleep as we were watching it." "Well, since I know you're telling the truth, then I'll leave." "Phew," you thought. Time skip. You got yourself the UA uniform, and unfortunately, you were in a different class. People already disliked you since they knew you were raised by a villain. At the break, you found Chōrō sitting by himself, reading. You smiled and sat next to him. "Hiya!" He jumped with fright. "Eep! Oh, hey, Wayan. What's with that reaction? I scared you, didn't I?" "No, well, yes, maybe." Chōrō had his face with the book. "How was your day, first day going in here?" "None of my classmates liked me at all," we slumped. "What am I going to do?" "You can still hang out with me," he responded, regaining some of his confidence. "Really? That's good. I also have Raka-chan and the others too." Chōrō began to blush at your cheery face. "So have you made any progress of being a hero?" "Yeah, it's kind of fun, but tiring at the same time," he smiled. Chōrō waited until the right time. He moved closely to you and spoke. "There's something I need to tell you." "Oh, what is it?" You felt a bit uncomfortable by the way he started at you, but your heart won't stop beating so fast. "I know we only met yesterday, but I've started liking you, and I want to go out with you." "Why is me out all of a sudden?" "Because I like you?" "That's a valid answer, I guess." Chōrō chuckled. The two of you laughed together, then the bell rang. It was the end of break. "I'll see you later then." You waved and walked to your classroom. After school, the YNA group returned back to the dorms. You were the last one who arrived at the dorm because the teacher held you back as if everything was okay. "YN," Momo came running to you. "What happened?" You took off your jacket and placed it on the rack. "It's a Todoroki-kun. It sounds like it's an emergency, you thought. You rushed to Shoto's room. You burst in and saw something you weren't expecting. "Oh, hello, I was expecting you, Wayan." Shoto spoke in his monotone voice as he was sipping his coffee. "What's going on?" you asked. "I thought there were an emergency, according to Momo." "What? Oh, I just want to hang out." Shoto planted out his outgoing with you. He told all of his friends, who literally the whole dorm, to set something you love. They didn't know what your taste was, so they guessed. "Here's something to drink." He handed your favorite drink to you. "How do you know this is my favorite?" He smiled. "I had some help. With some a long time." You two chatted. Just then you heard something. "Oh, it's about to start." Chōrō looked. "Oh, it's about to start." Chōrō looked out the window. "Follow me, Wayan." We led to an open window. Then a hint of light flew and a sudden blast of color spread across the deep blue sky. "Whoa, that's beautiful." Your eye-colored eyes shined from the fireworks. "You are too." You slightly blushed at his comment. "Thank you." "Wayan, can I ask you something?" You nodded, thinking you know what's about to happen. "Can you go out with me? As in boyfriend and girlfriend, I mean." You wanted to tease him. "Sorry." He sunk down. Not. "I would love to." He looked up with his mismatched eyes winded. He gave him a hug and kissed him on the head. Meanwhile, the rest of the group were watching from afar. Some were fangirling, while others were happy for them. "Oh, they look so adorable," Mom grinned. "Agreed," Ochako smiled. "This is stupid." Katsuki headed back to the dorm. But before he did, one of the girls spoke to the whole group like it's an announcement. "I think Bakugo-kun just jealous because he has no girlfriend." Oh, sick burn. Then by the explosion, I twitch. He literally blew up. "F off, sons of biatches." Then he ran off. His best friend, Ejima Kirishima, ran after him so he didn't do anything crazy. Sorry, I just had to laugh. Oh, Jesus. "Why not? Because him and Kirishima-kun are together," the acid girl, acid quirk user giggled. "Hey guys," everyone turned to Izuku. "I think Shoto and YN need some space." "I agree with you, Midoriya-kun." Tenya nodded. "Come on guys, we also have a training tomorrow." Most people were sighing and pouting. They dragged themselves back into the dorms. "Back to you and Shoto." "I think they stopped now." Shoto took another glance out the window. You giggled and leaned forward to connect your lips to his. While kissing, Shoto leaned forward so you were lying on the floor. It almost felt too good that you thought you were about to melt. Your lips parted with his. "Please don't tempt me anymore." Okay, that was the fanfic. Oh god, I fangirled. It was longer than I thought. Oh no, it's another 17 minutes video. I love this so much. Oh, I'm blushing. No. Okay. Well, I guess I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.